गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू डिस्कस द सब्जेक्ट क्वांटिटेटिव टेक्निक्स। अंडर दिस सब्जेक्ट वी हैव टू कवर दीज टॉपिक्स: लीनियर प्रोग्रामिंग, ट्रांसपोर्टेशन प्रॉब्लम, असाइनमेंट प्रॉब्लम, गेम एंड डिसीजन थ्योरी, सिमुलेशन, नेटवर्क एनालिसिस। सो लेट अस थ्रो सम लाइट ऑफ व्हाट वी आर लर्निंग इन दिस लेसन। फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल, व्हाट इज ऑपरेशन रिसर्च? ऑपरेशन रिसर्च एंड क्वांटिटेटिव टेक्निक्स आर सेम। ओके, सो ऑपरेशन रिसर्च इज द साइंस ऑफ रैशनल डिसीजन मेकिंग एंड द स्टडी, डिजाइन एंड इंटीग्रेशन ऑफ कॉम्प्लेक्स सिचुएशंस एंड सिस्टम्स विद द गोल ऑफ प्रिडिक्टिंग सिस्टम बिहेवियर एंड इम्प्रूविंग और ऑप्टिमाइजिंग सिस्टम परफॉर्मेंस। और वी कैन से दैट ओआर प्रोवाइड्स अ साइंटिफिक अप्रोच टू प्रॉब्लम सॉल्विंग फॉर एग्जीक्यूटिव मैनेजमेंट। It is assuming an increasing degree of importance in theory and practice of management, or it tries to find the best decision related to a large portion of the total organization. The decision which is best for the organization as a whole is called an optimal decision. According to scholar, OR is the application of scientific methods, techniques and tools to problem involving the operations of systems so as to provide these in control of the operations with optimum solution to the problem. Now, in this quantitative techniques, first of all, we will discuss linear programming. So, what is linear programming? It is a mathematical technique for optimum allocation of scarce or limited resources to several competing activities on the basis of given criterion of optimality, which can be either performance, return on investment, cost, utility, time, distance, etc. Or we can say that it is one of the most versatile, powerful and useful technique for making managerial decisions, or it is a mathematical technique to help management decide how to make most effective use of an organization resources. Now, what are the steps in LPP? Steps, first one is define decision variables, then formulate the objective function, then formulate the constraints, and last one is mention the non-negativity criteria. Next one is transportation problem. So, transportation problem deals with the transportation of a product manufactured at different plants of or factories to a number of different warehouses. In this problem, we have three methods: northwest corner method, least cost method, and Vogel's approximation method. And when it is feasible, the solution is said to be feasible when one gets m plus n minus 1 allotments. M for column, n stands for row. Okay, so this is the transportation problem. Next one is assignment problem. Assignment problem, it is a problem of assigning various people, machines and so on in such a way that the total cost involved is minimized or the total value is maximized. So, minimax theory, minimization and maximization. Okay, so the assignment problem refers to another special class of linear programming problem where the objective is to assign a number of resources to an equal number of activities on a one-to-one basis so as to minimize total cost of performing the task at hand or maximize total profit of allocations. Next one is decision theory. Decision theory, they are related to decisions making under conditions of certainty, then uncertainty, and last one is risk. Most of the business problems involve a certain degree of uncertainty about the future. And game theory, one of the most important variables affecting the success of an organization is its competition. It is a modeling technique for assessing the impact of a decision on one's competitors. Next one is simulation. So, first of all, we have to define the problem. then construction of an appropriate model, then experimentation with the model, then evaluation of the results of simulation. So simulation, it is a highly versatile technique of OR. It has a wide ranging application in business situations. It is a manipulation of a model constructed from the formal statements of mathematical representations in respect of logical relations between the elements in a structure or a system expressed in measurable terms. So this is the simulation. Next one is network analysis. Network is a graphical representation of a project depicting the flow as well as the sequence of well-defined activities and events. A network path consists of a set of activities that connects the networking beginning event to the network terminal event. The longest path through the network is called the critical path, and its length determines the minimum duration in which the said project can be completed. So here is the two methods, PERT and CPM, project evaluation and review technique, and CPM stands for critical path method. Now in this critical path method or PERT, an activity, what is activity, or we can say a task or job. So what is an activity? An activity or task or job is any portion of a project which consumes time or resources and has a definable beginning and ending. Okay, so for example, laying of a foundation of a building is an activity which requires the use of resources. In network, an activity is represented by an arrow which may be straight or bent but not broken. An activity must commence from some event. Then event, what is event? Event, the starting and finishing point of an activity or a group of activities are called events. In a like tail event, head event, so many events are in this critical path method. So assumptions of CPM, if I am talking about the assumptions of CPM and PERT, so what are the assumptions? Like a project can be subdivided into a set of predictable independent activities. Like activity times may be estimated either as a single point estimates or as 3 point estimates, optimistic, pessimistic, or most likely, and are independent of each other. So this is the network analysis. If I'm talking about the scope of OR, so scope of OR, where it is used? It is used in all over, like finance, budgeting, production, marketing management, purchasing, research and development. And what are the objectives? What are the objective to study this quantitative techniques? So objective is like to acquaint students with the construction of mathematical models for managerial decision situations and to use computer software packages to obtain a solution wherever applicable. The emphasis is on understanding the concept, formulation and interpretation. So this is all about the quantitative techniques. Thank you.